Musica is proudly presented by Rolex. They're ahead of their time. Visionary stage directors who want to entertain.
Just a beautiful voice really isn't enough. It has to be very, very good theatre.
To hit a nerve.
Man sitzt sozusagen direkt in einer Welt, die einen ganz körperlich ergreifen kann, wo Musik sozusagen, finde ich, auch auf den Nervenapparat direkt Zugriff hat.
And spread their message.
I don't do an opera if I don't see a version of it in the world that we live in.
Where do they get their ideas from? Which techniques and tools do they use? Visionary directors, how to reinvent opera. Opera, like in the movies. There's a new generation of stage directors who know how to add a modern twist to classical masterpieces, such as the epic tale of Faust, staged by Tobias Kratzer at Opera Bastille.
Faust ist ja eine Grand Opera und da war mir sehr klar, da muss auch wirklich ein Spektakel abbrennen. Für diesen großen Trip, den Faust und Mephisto dort in unserer Inszenierung durch Paris übernehmen, da müssen auch, muss auch eine Überfülle an Bildern haben.
Je pense que ce que Tobias a très très bien compris, c'est qu'on peut donner une idée contemporaine aujourd'hui de ce Faust, du thème, du sujet de Faust, mais avec des moyens d'aujourd'hui. Les vidéos, tout ça, ce qui est vraiment extrêmement bien fait, et qui du coup, pour le public, donne l'impression que c'est nous aujourd'hui, cette histoire.
German Tobias Kratzer won prestigious prizes and led productions at numerous international opera houses. The secret of his success? One ingredient. The same team, set and costume designer Rainer Selmayr and video artist Manuel Brown.
Es wird mit jedem Mal noch interessanter, weil also wir animieren uns eigentlich gegenseitig immer wieder vollständig neue Räume, aber auch sozusagen neue Ansätze zu Stücken zu entwickeln. Bei Moïse Pharaon war für uns von Beginn an noch nicht ganz klar, ob wir auf eine politische Lesart zielen, ob es vielleicht wirklich ein großer Glaubensdiskurs wird, ob Rossini all das mit seiner Musik unterläuft und gar nichts davon das Thema ist. Und irgendwann kommt dann der Moment der Wahrheit, wo man sich tatsächlich für einen Zugang entscheiden und den dann aber auch sehr, sehr konsequent machen muss.
For Rossini's opera about Moses' exodus from Egypt, they drew a parallel with the refugee crisis.
Wir haben einmal Situation ein Flüchtlingslager, das ist auf der einen Seite wirklich wie Ruinen oder Sand oder irgendwie verlassene Häuser und auf der anderen Seite jetzt für die westliche Zivilisation, so dieses Großraumbüro von irgendwie so einer westlichen NGO.
Like in other of Kratzer's productions, a video projection plays an important role. It shows the exodus, but was filmed in Marseille.
Für mich war das auch das erste Mal, dass man mit Unterwasserkameramännern gearbeitet hat. Wir hatten da zwei Taucher, die unter Wasser gefilmt. Und das war eine sehr aufwendige Produktion. Und es war auch ein sehr tolles Abenteuer. Und ja, wir haben da sozusagen, wenn sich das Meer, das gespaltene Meer wieder schließt und die Ägypter dann ertrinken, das versucht da einzufangen.
During the rehearsal, the film sequence has to be adjusted to the conductor's pace.
Cool wäre, wenn da direkt der Schuh fallen würde.
Ja, und das leitet den Tempowechsel ein. Genau, den antizipieren wir an der Stelle.
Okay, super. Und dann fällt der Schuh. Wenn der auf die Straße fällt, ist der.
Ja.
Okay,
I think Tobias is fabulous. He is like the whisper of big, crazy pieces that like I would never know how to direct. Like he does this big, like there's this style called like grand opéra, which is like these crazy like five act French things, and nobody can crack those like Tobias.
Lydia Steyer, another talented and award-winning stage director. She's progressive, a feminist, not afraid of provoking, and one of the few female stage directors in Europe.
Being a woman in this business, you have to behave differently than men. And you have to be aware of the difference in the perception of certain reactions based on your gender. For instance, a man that has a temper tantrum and runs out of the room is a perfectionist. A woman that does that is hysterical. Exact same behavior, exact same situation. And so I've learned over time that you have to control for that.
First, the American wanted to become a singer, but quickly she changed plans. She's famous for her visually intense staging.
You're looking at these enormous forces. Like, I mean, when you see the Frauenschatten, it is literally 350 people working in concert, like in perfect coordination to create this thing that is designed to move you on the inside. All right, also Vivian, I'd love you to run and stand on the bed when you see her.
Die Frau ohne Schatten. A challenging work full of symbols influenced by Freud's interpretation of dreams.
All of my designers know that there have to be rolling elements, there have to be, like I love a staircase, that there have to be the ability of quicker changes and movement. The transitions and the movement of elements is the absolute key to this entire set and to the storytelling. And in that case, it's not really possible to make all the shapes that need to happen on stage without being able to play with them with your hands. There's no such thing as a traditional staging. Like, you have to reflect the time, the political pressures of a moment.
Movie musicals and Broadway, that's what Steyer grew up with. Modern inspirations that shape her opera productions.
You know, the idea is to sort of like seduce an audience, like to get them entertained and excited about a visual language, and then twist the knife a little bit and say, don't you see yourselves in this? Like, this is about us. Every piece that I ever direct has to be about us.
Lydia's, I mean, I feel as if she has such a dramatic focus on performance and storytelling. You feel really like you see very clearly what the kind of narrative of the opera is, but you feel like it's brought into sharp focus by the performers.
Here's another award-winning stage director, the Swiss-Australian Simon Stone. Before moving to Europe, he was described as the enfant terrible of Australian theatre. As a director, he wants his cast to improvise and participate in the creative process.
If you want to achieve something new, you have to be working in a way that is unknown to you. Like, we don't challenge ourselves enough as artists, I think, to really kind of put ourselves into situations where we're not specialists. I'm constantly moving between art forms and I'm constantly having to kind of catch up.
What are they?
Moving between art forms by directing plays, operas, and even films.
Mr. Brown is an archaeologist.
Ye gods!
Mrs. Pretty, I think you'd better come and see.
Many Many of his opera stagings are also famous for being cinematographic. A realistic and intimate approach that matches especially well with the contemporary production Innocence, composed by Kaya Sarriaro, an opera featuring a school massacre.
You listen to the music and you compose pictures thinking, what film would I make to that score? You need to celebrate the piece of music for what it is. And if you don't like the music, you shouldn't be making the opera. The only way operas keep getting put on is by proving that they have a relevance to the world that we live in. So that's, I think, the simplest way of making sure that audiences feel like opera is indispensable as an art form.
Modern subjects, classics that still matter today, and impactful staging. This is what opera should be made of in the 21st century.
Musica was proudly presented by Rolex.